In today's video, we're going to break down the differences between two incredible dog breeds, the Labrador Retriever and the Golden Retriever. Welcome back to the Femrear Labrador Show. If this is your first time here, my name's Will. I'm a canine behaviorist and I'm the founder and CEO of FemrearCanineLeaders.com. This channel is dedicated to helping you learn everything that you could possibly ever want to know about the glorious Labrador Retriever and then how to become high-level canine leaders that raise perfect Labrador companions. So if you're a lifelong lab lover thinking about getting one and you've just started your new journey with your Labrador, then this channel is for you. So make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn on the notification bell, and you never miss a future Labrador video. So let's start by talking about the origins of these two insanely popular retrievers, and we'll begin with the Labrador Retriever, seeing as it is the Labrador show. Now, to understand the Lab's origins, we need to first look at another breed, and that is the now sadly extinct St. John's Water Dog. This breed originated in Newfoundland, Canada. This breed caught the attention of two British aristocrats. First, James Harris, and the second, Earl of Malmesbury. He imported the breed to England in the 1800s. With the intention of breeding shooting companions. A few years later, the breed caught the attention of Walter Scott, the 5th Duke of Buccleuch, who started his own breeding program. Now, for years, these two breeding programs continued pretty separately, and it wasn't until a chance meeting between their two sons that the two kennel lines were united. Now, this is when the breeding of the Labrador Retriever really began to become established here in England. And a little bonus fact is that the Labrador was named after the Labrador Sea, which borders around Newfoundland Island, where they actually kind of originated from. And it wasn't until 1903 until the Labrador had become an officially recognised breed by the Kennel Club here in England. And it took 14 more years, 1917, for the breed to be recognised by the American Kennel Club. Again, another bonus cheeky fact is that all recorded Labradors were black in colour until 1892, when the first chocolate Labradors were recorded, followed by the first recorded yellow labs in 1899. Now, the Labrador surged in popularity in the US, becoming the most registered dog breed in 1991, and it is a title and accomplishment it still holds today as the most popular dog breed in the US. Now, for the history of the Golden Retriever. So the Golden Retriever, on the other hand, compared to the Labrador, hails from the Scottish Highlands. It was developed by Dudley Madgery Banks, the first Lord of Tweedmouth. He wanted to create the ideal gun dog that could handle the rain and rugged terrain around his home in the Scottish Highlands. Now, he used a few breeds in the creation of the Golden Retriever. Dudley's Yellow Retriever, or so he called it in his records, some Irish Setter, a little dash of Bloodhounds, and the now extinct Tweed Water Spaniel. Now, throwing in another cheeky bonus fact here is that Dudley spent 50 years developing the breed between 1840 and 1890. Now, the Golden did not make its debut in the English show ring all the way until 1908. It was also at this time that the breed was being imported over to Canada, allowing its way into the US. Now, in the States, the breed captured the attention of both sportsmen and those in the show ring for its versatility and extreme beauty. And again, another little bonus fact here, the Golden got a rise in fame in the 1970s thanks to US President General Ford and his Golden Retriever, Liberty. Now, let's go over the looks of these two different breeds and where they're different. Now, the Labrador is a medium-sized dog. Height for males is around 22.5 inches to 24.5 inches, and weighing around 65 to 80 pounds or 29 to 36 kilograms, with females just being a little bit shorter and a little bit lighter, which is very common amongst most dog breeds. Colours accepted by breed standards are yellow, black and chocolate, though other colours are making an appearance in the breed along with some controversy, as is the case with any kind of change in old long lineage breeds, and those colours are silver, charcoal, champagne and red. Now, Labradors have a muscular build, very kind eyes, a short, dense, weather-resistant coat and a thick otter-like tail. Now, the Golden Retriever is also a medium-sized dog and is close in size to the Labrador, with males being 23 to 24 inches and around 65 to 75 pounds, which is 29 to 34 kilos. And again, the females are usually an inch or two shorter and then a few kilograms or a few pounds lighter. Accepted colours for the Golden Retriever are light gold all the way through to dark gold, but the breed does also come in cream, red and white. The Golden Retriever is known for its thick, luxurious, water-repellent coat that can occur in either straight or wavy, as well as its friendly, intelligent eyes, short ears and that lovely straight muzzle. One physical trait both the Labrador and the Golden Retriever share is their webbed toes, which aids them in their incredible swimming abilities. For the intelligence and trainability, these two breeds are pretty evenly matched. These are some of the most trainable dogs in the world, and they excel at many different things. They have been used all over the world for retrieval in particular. They have also been highly successful in many other jobs, such as search and rescue, narcotics detection, bomb detection, and a variety of different service dog roles, with the Labrador being the most popular choice for rescue and service work. Now, both of these breeds absolutely adore their people. They are incredibly loving and want nothing more than to please. This results in a very biddable dog and contributes to their extremely high levels of trainability. Now, again, a little bonus fact to throw in is that the first three dogs to ever receive an AKC Obedience Championship title were all Golden Retrievers. So what about the temperaments of these two breeds? Well, they do share a lot of traits, as they are both retrievers and both bred to do similar things. There are a few key differences. But first, what traits do these breeds actually share? Because I think that is important, a place to start. As both of the Labrador and the Golden Retrievers are known to be incredibly loyal, loving companions. They are very sociable breeds and tend to get along well with everyone if given a good foundation of training and socialization. These two breeds are also great with children. They also do very well with other dogs and animals if introductions and socialization is done correctly. Now, moving on to the differences, you will find that the Lab is slightly more higher energy than the Golden Retriever, especially Labradors like my Sully that come from more working lines. The Labrador also tends to be a little bit more boisterous and outgoing, whereas the Golden Retriever is also friendly, but it does tend to fall on the more gentle reserve side. It was mentioned earlier that these two breeds both absolutely love their people. They adore spending time with their owners and families, and they have a hard time being left alone for long periods of time, which can lead to separation anxiety. So if you are considering either of these breeds, that might be something that you're going to have to consider. And now for our final and last section, and we're going to discuss what are the exercise and grooming differences between these two breeds. Now, the Labrador Retriever and the Golden Retriever are both, obviously, working breeds, so they require a large amount of daily physical activity to keep them content and relaxed. Being retrievers, they both enjoy an amazing game of fetch with a ball or frisbee. They also love long walks and hikes, and swimming is the favoured activity, with Labs in particular being drawn to water on hikes or wherever they can find it, and I can promise you as a Lab owner, I can attest to a very common, wet, smelly dog whenever he has the chance. Both breeds have double coats, which helps to repel water and to keep them warm, so they will both require a good weekly brushing. Though, as expected, Goldens do tend to be a little bit more labour intensive when it comes to grooming due to their long coats, and they require more rigorous brushing. They also tend to need to be bathed more to keep their fur in good condition. The Golden Retriever also requires some trimming of its coat to keep it from getting matted too long or tangled. Now, lastly, as with most breeds with floppy ears, they do need more regular ear cleanings to prevent any ear infections, especially if they're often going for a good splash or swim in dirty water. And sadly, as with most popular breeds, the Labrador and the Golden Retriever do have quite numerous health concerns that is worthwhile being aware of before going into one of these breeds. Some of the more common risks include hip and elbow and knee dysplasia, variety of skin issues like hot spots, there's some eye problems, and like we just mentioned, ear infections. Now, common health issues in the Labrador breed include entropion, which is a defect in the dog's eyelids, hyperthyroidism, laryngeal paralysis, which sometimes presents in older Labs and produces a muffled barking noise, and some health problems that are more specific to Golden Retrievers do include kind of seizure disorders, hyperthyroidism, and they are particularly susceptible to some cancers. Now, I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, make sure you hit that like button and get involved down in the comment section below. And don't forget that if you are new here, to make sure that you subscribe. We have two dedicated Labrador videos coming here every single week. So I cannot wait to talk to you again on the next episode of the Fenrir Labrador Show.